Children, in the last presentation, we dealt about the temperature, pressure, and density of the Earth. Today, we are going to deal with the different layers of the Earth's interior. As we all know that we cannot directly study the interior of the Earth. So that study will have to be based on the physical and chemical property of the Earth's surface, like the behavior pattern of the seismic waves of the earthquake. Not only that, varying density and other physical and chemical properties of the rock and the lava that has erupted from the volcanoes has given us some insight as to the interior of the Earth. So the Earth's interior, it's like a grand onion, and it is made up of concentric layers. And the three concentric layers of the Earth's interior is crust, mantle, and core. We are going to deal with this one by one. First, we are going to deal with the crust. So crust, it is also known as lithosphere. Why is it known as lithosphere? Because it has been derived, lithos has been derived from the word, Greek word, that is lithos, meaning the rock. Since it is covered with rock, that is why it is also known as lithosphere or rock sphere. Then the thickness of the crust, it is 6 to 48 kilometers thick, and it is the outermost layer of the Earth's surface. And it consists of two layers, that is Cl and Sima. Cl, it is also known as the continental crust, and the Sima, it is known as the oceanic crust. And the crust, it is thicker underneath the continent than underneath the ocean, or the continental crust, it is thicker than the oceanic crust. This Cl that we are talking about, it consists of solid and continental part of the Earth's crust, and it is composed of a rock type which is known as the granite. And this granite layer that is there, it is also called Cl. That's because in Cl it consists of silicate and aluminium. That's why it is known as Cl. The density of Cl is 2.7. Now we will talk about another part of the Earth's crust, that is the Sima. So Sima, it has a density and composition of basalt. So the combination of the Sima, it is quite different. It is basically combined of manganese and silicate. So that way the density also varies, and its density is similar to the basalt, that is the black volcanic rock. Now we will talk about the crust as a whole. Okay, the crust as a whole, it is thickest beneath the mountain, and it is thinnest underneath the ocean. And it consists of different types of rock. Okay, and the most importantly, the uppermost layer of the crust, it consists of sedimentary rock, and the thickness of that sedimentary rock, it varies from place to place. Like in the case of the Fold Mountain, underneath the Fold Mountain, the thickness is 3.2 to 32 kilometers, and in some other places, it is still thinner. And we can also say, we can conclude by saying that the Cl is a discontinuous layer which is floating over the continuous layer of Sima. Let's talk about the second layer, that is the mantle. And the mantle, it is bounded by Mohorovic in the discontinuity in the upper part, and Gutenberg discontinuity in the lower part. So we can say that the mantle, it is separated from the crust by Mohorovic discontinuity, and it is separated from the core by Gutenberg discontinuity. And its thickness is about 35 to 2900 kilometers. So that is the thickness of the depth of the mantle. And it is made up of dense and heavy material. So it is made up of very dense and heavy material such as oxygen, iron, magnesium. That is why its density varies from 3.3 to 3.7. The mental, it is divided into two parts, that is, the upper part or the upper mental is known as asthenosphere, and the lower mental, it is known as the mesosphere. And the upper mental or asthenosphere, it consists of magnesium, iron, silicate, and some amount of sulfide as well. Whereas the lower mental or mesosphere, it consists of nickel, iron, okay? And the temperature of this layer, that is the mantle, it varies between, ranges between 900 degree to 2200 degree centigrade. And because of very high temperature, the rock in this layer is in the form of magma. And sometimes the pressure of the overlying layer keeps the lower part of the crust and upper part of the mantle so in a solid state. That's because of the pressure. But if temperature is concerned, the material should be in liquid or molten state. We are going to deal with the last layer, that is the core, and it lies below the mantle, and is around the center of the earth. It is the deepest layer. We can say it is the deepest layer of the earth, and it consists of nickel and iron alloy. That is why it is also known as knife. And the temperature that is estimated in the core, it is around, in the outer core, it is estimated to be between 700 degrees centigrade, and in the inner core, it is estimated to be 4000 degree centigrade. So the outer core is in molten state. The outer core, it is in molten state, whereas the inner core, it is in solid state. That's because of very high pressure. Around about 3 million tons of pressure is there at the center of the earth's surface. That's why the outer core, it is in molten state, but the inner core, it is in solid state. And the density, it is ranging from 14.7 to 16 density. So the presence of heavy metal and iron that may be responsible for the earth's magnetism as well. The earth, it has magnetism. That's because of the presence of heavy metal in the core. Magnetism is there. So girls, today we dealt with the three layers of the earth's crust. We hope you've understood it. In the next class, I will be giving question and answers related to this topic. Bye bye, and take care of yourself, girls. Please study.